स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम हियर विद द हिस्ट्री सब्जेक्ट ऑफ क्लास 8 एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री दैट इज द बर्थ ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया. हियर आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग यू पार्ट फर्स्ट एंड लेट्स हैव अ लुक व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन पार्ट फर्स्ट. सो फर्स्ट इज द इंट्रोडक्शन, राइज ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया, ट्रांजिशन इन यूरोपियन सोसाइटी, इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन, results of industrial revolution, key features of industrial revolution, keywords colonization. So let's begin. Introduction. Students, the modern period of the Indian history began after the death of the Aurangzeb, after the death of the Mughal ruler Aurangzeb in 1707. As I have provided you the revision part of class 7th and I have explained you this, that the Mughal period was divided into two parts. So during the period after the death of Aurangzeb, the period of great Mughals extinct. And after that, the period started, that was the period of the later Mughal. The rulers of the later Mughals were not that powerful to hold the whole empire as one. Its advantage was only taken by the European countries. So whenever, according to the historians, the modern period of the Indian history started from 1707 only. Now this was the period when people from different European countries has reached the Indian soil. Now this was the period when the people of the European countries started coming to India. It is not like that they started coming after the death of Aurangzeb only. Many a times we have seen that during the period of Jahangir also, one British ambassador came to India for requesting for the trade concession rights. And after that, in the period of Aurangzeb also, one British ambassador came, and the Portuguese from the European, they came in 1498 only in India. So many countries from the European power coming to India, Indian subcontinent, but after the declination of the Mughal Empire, they got the power that we will see. Now, people from different European countries had reached the Indian soil much earlier. That means they are coming from much earlier time. Not only after the death of Aurangzeb or not only after 1707, many European countries are coming way much earlier. Among them, the Portuguese were the first who came here in 1498. So if someone asks that which European power firstly came to India, our answer will be Portuguese. Now, the British, the Dutch and the French also came to India for the trading purposes. All these European countries were coming to India for the trading purpose. Why they were coming for the trading purposes for India, that we will see in further slides, but I'm giving you the reason. The British, the Dutch and the French, or wherever European countries are there, they were coming to India for the trading purposes in search of the markets for their production goods. Means they were coming here for selling their goods, and they were also coming here for the search of the raw materials. As all of us are knowing that the spices, the textiles, the cotton textiles, silk, spices are very famous of India. Now, the period after, means the period of the later Mughals, the period after 1707 was the period that the road to their political, economic and cultural domination over Indian subcontinent was paved. As they were coming here for their trading purposes, earlier there was no motto of them to control us politically, economically or culturally. But when they were coming here for the trading purposes and they saw the condition of the Indians, Indian subcontinent, that the rulers of the India only fighting among themselves, and then there is no single power who can hold whole empire. So they took advantage of that condition and they started controlling politically, economically and culturally over Indian subcontinent. The modern period began with the grant of trading rights by the Indian rulers to the European trading companies. Many Indian rulers started providing trading rights, that means the right to sell and buy goods in India, to the many European powers. It reached high pitch with conflict among them for supremacy in trade and politics. Now, the powers, the Portuguese, the British, the Dutch, and the French, all of them were fighting in India for gaining more and more profit. So, the conflict started among them also for the supremacy in trade in India and for controlling politically India. That means all the European countries, those who were coming for the trading purpose, all of them were willing to establish trade supremacy in India and they all wanted to control us politically. So for the same reason, they only started fighting among themselves. After successfully fighting number of battles against their French rivals and some powerful Indian rulers, now Britishers were there. Britishers were the most powerful and they were able to successfully fight or successfully defeat the French rivals. At last, they were only French were left with the Britishers. Dutch and Portuguese were already gone. So French Britishers fought with the French rivals and some powerful Indian rulers also. The British emerged dominant power in the Indian subcontinent. So basically we can say that European countries started coming to India very much earlier, but earlier their motto was to trade in India only. After the death of Aurangzeb in 1707, as the Indian subcontinent started weakening and there was no powerful ruler in the Indian subcontinent who can hold, the kingdom was divided into many regional powers and they all were fighting among themselves for conquering or for controlling whole India. Taking its advantage, it paved the path for the European countries to control us politically also or to establish trade supremacy among us. Now, as the countries started coming to India for the trading purposes, for selling their goods, for the market, for selling their goods, or for purchasing raw materials from here, they saw the condition of India and they started planning to conquer India politically. After they only started fighting among themselves and British was the most powerful, after successfully defeating its French rivals and the Indian rulers, Britishers were able to emerge dominant power in the subcontinent. This was only the introduction. If someone asks when is the modern period started in India, our answer will be 1707. Now, the political rise of modern India. The period between 1707 to 1757 marked the formative year of British rule in India. From 1707 till 1757, this was the starting period of Britishers, when Britishers were struggling in India for establishing their political control. This period also saw the decline and disintegration of the Mughal Empire. We have already seen in our revision chapter that from 1707 till 1757 was the period of the later Mughals in India. So when Britishers were struggling for establishing, for stabilizing themselves in India, this was the time in India when the Mughal Empire were declining and disintegrating. And this was only the time when the independent regional states were emerging. All the European countries were indulged in trade wars and conflict over the issues of their mercantile interest and aspirations. This was the time only when all the European countries were fighting among themselves for the trade supremacy. The period. So from 1707 till 1757, many incidents took place. This was a period when the Britishers were struggling in India. This was a period when European countries were fighting among themselves for establishing their trade supremacy. This was a period when the Mughal Empire was declining and disintegrating. This was the period of the emergence of the regional power or regional states. Now, after that, the period from 1757 till 1947. In 1947, India got independent. So, we divide this also in two parts. From 1757 till 1857 was the period when the Britishers started expanding themselves politically in the Indian subcontinent. They started conquering many kingdoms, like we have learned about Awadh, Hyderabad, Marathas, Mysore. All were they started controlling all the regions, Calcutta, Bombay, Surat. They all started conquering all these parts of India. In 1857, we are knowing the famous battle of independence that was known as First War of Independence. From 1857 till 1947, we will see that how India was fighting for the freedom of its country. So this modern period is also divided, basically we can say that modern period is divided into, usko bhi, we can divide in three parts, 1707 to 1757. This was the formative years of the Britishers, when Britishers were struggling here. From 1757 till 1857, they started expanding themselves politically. From 1857 till 1947, we will saw the struggle of Indians for their freedom. Now, transition in European society. What exactly happened during the modern period? The term modern was originally used for the period of European history. This is the word that is started from the European history. Like, the ancient, medieval and modern is not the period that is only relating to the Indian history. The changes were going on in the whole world. There was many changes take place during the modern time, your modern period of the history. The word modern means, why it is known as modern period, students? This was the time when many new ideas, philosophies and institutions started gaining popularity. Aristotle, Plato and many other new, Karl Marx and many other new ideas, philosophers came into existence, new political institution, the ideas of equality, liberty started taking form. So this was only the time when it was a modern period in true sense. This was a period of development, the new means and technologies of production. So now the countries started thinking about the new technologies, how they can increase their production, and they started undertaking expedition, means they started expanding to distant land, to different lands. They started expanding their power. The European world enters into a new period where all these developments started with the collapse of feudal system. In European also at that time, French Revolution was also taking place, American War of Independence was going on, World War and all that. That was only the result of the modern ideas. At that time only, the society was modernizing and developing. In that form only, there was the introduction of the Industrial Revolution. Industrial Revolution is the changes that took place in the field of industries that we will see. Many other important events also took place in the modern period, such as the American War of Independence, the French Revolution, World War First and Second. So basically what we have seen, that the word modern means the emergence of new ideas, philosophies and institutions. Means the development started taking place, the society started changing, the thoughts of liberty and equality started coming into existence. Now, what is Industrial Revolution? The Industrial Revolution was a series of changes that take place in the year 18th and 19th century, series of changes that was started in Europe. The Industrial Revolution started in Europe during the 18th and 19th century. What was Industrial Revolution? It was a series of changes which influenced the growth of the modern European society. It was a time only when different changes started taking place and it started modernizing the European countries. These changes were caused by the introduction of new technologies and invention of new mechanical devices. This was the time when the people started developing new technologies and new machineries started building. England was the first, please do remember it, England was the first European country where the Industrial Revolution firstly started. So it was England only where the Industrial Revolution started first time. Subsequently, from England, the Industrial Revolution started spreading to all over Europe, North America and the rest of the world. Its effect was also seen in India. Students, as the Industrial Revolution started, I will tell you what were the main key features of the Industrial Revolution. Industrial Revolution says moving from rural agriculture, that means it focused on rather than it started focusing rather than other fields on then agriculture, means agriculture ke alawa bhi they started doing different they started developing in different fields. So basically they started coming to the migration started, people started moving from the rural areas to the city areas for working in the factory system was started. Factory system means the production of goods started in the factories, laborers were hired, they were provided wages, new machines were established in the factories, working hours were limited, capital was started investing in the factories, mass production of goods means large amounts of goods started producing, increased efficiency means the power of doing work, that means earlier the work was going on or the production was going on with manual, that means with the hand. Now increased efficiency means they started introducing machines, reduced average cost by producing the goods with the machines, the price of the goods started decreasing, enable more to be produced, that is only enable mass production of goods means they started enabling more and more goods, promoting industries and capital investment, they started promoting industries, they started establishing different industries and capital investment, firstly they will put some investment, a capital, put amount, put some money, then only they started producing, invention of new machines, this was the time when the new machines were invented, it was the time of the rise of steam power, steam engines were there, steam trains, spinning wheel was also invented this time only, railways was also invented and steam power machine, the machines that can run with the steam. So this was only the key features of Industrial Revolution. Now what was the result of the Industrial Revolution, we will see. Result of Industrial Revolution. Students, as the Industrial Revolution spread throughout the world, now this revolution started spreading throughout the world, now every country wants to compete, every country wants to be superior than the other. So this competition began among the European powers including England, France and other. Now as the Industrial Revolution started and the production of goods increases, now the two things were in more demand. First of all, since we are producing more and more goods, so we can only get the profit when we will sell it in the market. So the first demand was the market, that means the place where they can sell their goods, they were in search of market. Next was, since the production was increased, so to produce anything raw materials are needed. Now the countries, the European countries, were in great need of the raw materials, and now they started searching the countries, those who were having the raw materials that they need, and they started searching for the markets also to explore those regions that are beyond their own frontiers. Now what they started exploring, this was also the feature of the Industrial Revolution, that they will expand their limit, they will expand their power for the markets of their product and for the regular supply of the raw materials. So their domestic means the industries that were in their country can run. This marked the beginning of the age of colonization. From here only the colonization started. So what was the result of Industrial Revolution? As the Industrial Revolution spread out in whole world, the competition started beginning between the European powers. They all wanted to expand themselves. They all wanted markets for their produced goods. They all wanted regular supply of raw materials for supplying their goods. This was only the period of the colonization. Now we will see how the colonization started. Before learning, first we will know the meaning of colonization. Colonization, as it is written, the action or process of settling among and establishing control over the indigenous people of an area. Colonization means a powerful country started conquering a weaker country, started living there and controlling and established their control over the people of that country, like England did. What the England did was a process of colonization only. England came to India and they started controlling us, started the indigenous people, matlab the people those who are belonging to India. So that was the process of colonization. Now, if we will take example of India and England. So England did the colonization process. England is the imperial country. Means England is that powerful country that is ruling over India. And here India is the colony that is ruled by England. So what is a colony? A country or area under the full or partial political control of another country and occupied by settlers from that country. Means India was occupied by England. India was occupied by the Britishers, so India became their colony. And imperialism, what is imperialism? Is the practice of a larger country. Means the larger country like England or the government of England, stronger by taking over poorer or weaker countries that have important resources. That means India was having raw materials. India was very famous for its resources, and that is why England or the Britishers wanted to conquer us. So this is only the three concepts are clear. Colonization, that means to overpower any country or to establish their control over the indigenous people of an area. Colony is a country that is ruled by a stronger country. Imperialism is the process of ruling or governing other poor or weaker country that have important resources. Now we will see what is colonization. Colonization signifies the subjugation of a country by a more powerful country. Colonization signifies the subjugation. What is the meaning of the word subjugation? Subjugation means to overpower karna. So colonization signifies the subjugation of a country by a more powerful country. Like what England did? England did the process of colonization. They subjugated us. They overpower us. Now next, what is the result? Now what happened after that? It results for many political, economic, social and cultural changes in the country that is ruled. Now the country that they are ruling, they will change it. They will change it politically, they will change it economically. They started controlling their economically, socially, politically. They changed their culture also. They totally established their control over the indigenous people of that country. The country that is ruled is called colony. That means the country that is ruled by means the weaker country is called colony, and the country that is ruling, and the country that is ruling is the imperialist country. Now, what was the fundamental goal of the imperialist country? Why any country overpower any country? They wanted to fulfill their desires. So what was the fundamental goal? The first one is to exploit the economy of its country. Since the colony country is rich in resources, and the powerful country was in need of raw materials. So basically they will exploit the economy. They will started selling their goods at higher prices. They will started purchasing raw materials from them at lower prices, derived the maximum benefit out of it. They will started deriving maximum benefit. They will utilize our human, human resources. They will utilize our land, our fields for growing their own raw materials. We will see further all this. Bring prosperity to the country. What was the motto of the imperialist country? They want to bring more and more money to their country to grow their domestic industries. They depend upon the colony for the fulfillment of the raw materials. Now what happened to the colony? What happened to the weaker country? Colonization leads to poverty in the colony. There was no any powerful ruler. So the people, since the drain of wealth started, the wealth started draining towards the imperialist country. So colonization leads to the poverty in the colony. Resources drained out of the economy. Since they attracted towards the resources of the colony only, they started exploiting the resources also. Thank you, students. After this, we will see the colonization of India, the changes, and the resources of learning the modern history.